Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome, man. Welcome to Beyond Classic Rock. Today, I've got an album reaction for you, man, and it's featuring the music of an artist named David Sylvian. And the album is called Secrets from the Beehive, released in 1987. So before I pop this off, man, I just want to give a shout out and a thanks to VoiceOver. VoiceOver, thanks, man. I appreciate the recommendation. And also introducing me and maybe a few other people to a new artist. So, VoiceOver says, Hi Wayne, I have an album recommendation, David Sylvian's Secrets from the Beehive from 87. David Sylvian's voice, I think, is unique and always moving, and this is a very special solo album. It's a beautiful album, very atmospheric and poetic. I won't get into too much. I think the songs should speak for themselves. Hopefully you'll enjoy. All the best, VoiceOver. Right on, man. Thank you very much. So, let us hit this up, man, and see what David Sylvian is all about. Let's go all the way through. Okay, Secrets from the Beehive. Let's get it.
The sun shines high above, the sounds of laughter. The birds swoop down upon the crosses of old gray churches. We say that we're in love, or secretly wishing.
Oh, was that it? Damn. That was only like a minute. Okay. September.
He knows well his wicked ways and cause of bitterness. A grudge held from his childhood days as if life had loved him less. Reading down his list of names, he ticks them one by one. He points the barrel at the sky, firing shots off at the sun. Out the victims' names in the wooden butt of the gun. He leans well back against the tree. He knows his kingdom's come. Breathe a sigh, self-satisfied. The work is in good hands. He shoots the coins into the air and follows where the money lands. I am the Lord and I am the King. I am the wisdom, listen to me. Pauses at the city's edge of hellfire and of stone. summons up the devil there to give him courage of his own. He'll free the sinners of deceit, they'll hear his name and run. His justice is his own reward, measured out beneath the sun.
Man, that is some song. Got me thinking about so many different places they can go with it. And of course, you know, you're making your own conclusions. So, Maria.
Thank you.
He's waiting to be reunited with Maria. Good tune. I visualize him just sitting there and just focusing and meditating on her.
Standing firm on this stony ground, the wind blows hot, pulls these clothes around. I harbor all the same worries as most, the temptations to leave or to give up the ghost. I wrestle with an outlook on life that shifts between darkness and shadowy light. I struggle fear that they'll hear, but Orpheus sleeps on his back, still dead to the world. Sunlight falls, my wings open wide, there's a beauty here I cannot deny. Bottles that tumble and crash on the stairs are just so many people I knew never cared. Down below on the wreck of the ship are a stronghold of pleasures I couldn't regret. But the baggage is swallowed up by the tide as Orpheus keeps to his promise and stays by my side. Tell me, I've still these fires never stop, believe me. When this joke is tired of laughing, I will hear the promise of my Orpheus soon.
Wasn't Orpheus a musician? I think in Greek mythology, something like that. He was able to sing and entrance you, something like that. Oh, listen to that sexy sax. I almost forgot what I was saying.
Just you, the weather, and I gave up hope. But all of the hurdles that fell in our laps was fuel for the fire and straw for our backs. Still the voices of stories to tell of the power struggles in heaven and hell. But we feel secure against such mighty dreams as Orpheus sings of the promise tomorrow may bring.
Orpheus sings. I think this is focusing on the state that you're in when you're under Orpheus's spell and influence.
Still a lot to learn, understand. These fires never stop, please believe. When this joke is tired of laughing, I will hear the promise of my Orpheus.
That was an excellent song, man. I love that.
The night is dark and cold.
The devil's home.
Strong winds and the rain crack the branches up on my window. The devil beats his drum, casting out his spell, dragging all his own down into hell. The ticking of the clock inexorably goes on. The howling of the stray souls of heaven, treasures of the cove where the traders stored their gold, echo voices still dead to the world. Underneath the vine, shaded by the leaves, I still hold you close. Sunrise won't be long when darkness hides inside its own shadow. The devil beats his drum, casting out his name, dragging all his own down into shame.
Good tune. Like I said, meditative. When poets dreamed of angels.
Early from bed, runs to the mirror, the bruises inflicted in moments of fury. He kneels beside her once more, whispers a promise, next time I'll break every bone in your body. Let the devil in. And if the river ran dry, they'd deny it happening. As the card players steal their hands from the bottom of the deck, row upon row of away. Medicine for the popular complaint. When the poets dreamed of angels, what did they see? History lined up in a flash at their backs. When the poets dreamed of angels, what did they see? Bishops and knights were placed to a time.
Instrumentals on the back end. I was still trying to kind of break down the song in my mind. Still thinking about
shadows
this threat
fall,
to break every bone in our body.
Knights and pawns upon the squares. Blood is drawn up from the well. Secret signs brought the crime right to your door. An innocent, guilty as hell. Oh, the court is open wide. Child, in Jesus' name. Thank you. should they be waiting there on my return? I may run into their arms, walking on a razor's edge, unconcerned. Lost again, I'll never learn.
Struggling to overcome the rest of that elusive mass known as wisdom.
Watching as the gulls all settle down upon the empty vessels, the faded whites of their wedding gowns, the songs of hopeless selflessness. December sun, the cold that blisters the hands of a working man wasted. Waiting on the empty docks, watching the ships roll in. I'm longing for the agony to stop, or let the happiness in. Listen to the waves against the rocks. I don't know where they've been. I'm waiting for the sky to open up and let the happiness in. Let the happiness in. Let the happiness in, 'cause it's coming, coming on. Let the happiness in. Thank you. calling on. Let the happiness in. Cause it's coming, coming on.
Need of a shift of energy and state of being and mind, living that quiet desperation. Good song. Waterfront.
On the banks of the sunset beach, messages scratched in sand. Beneath the roaming home of stars, young boys try their hands. Spanish harboring of sorts in Catalonian bars. They were pulled from a sinking ship and saved for last. On the waterfront, the rain pouring in my heart. Hear the memories come in waves, raking in the lost and found of years. And though I'd like to laugh with all the things that led me on, somehow the stigma still. Watch the train steam full ahead as it takes the bend. Empty carriages lose their tracks, tumble to their end. So the world streams drop by drop as the wine goes to your head. Swollen angels point and laugh. This time your God is dead. On the waterfront, the rain is pouring in my heart. Hear the memories coming way. Breaking in the lost and found of years. And though I'd like to laugh all the things that led me on, somehow the stigma still clutching. tide, a rosary. The rain upon her lips, eyes opened with a kiss, just too late for us to see. She sits upon the ground, face covered by a shroud of midnight canopy. And when the lightning starts, the secrets in her heart merge within the rain pattern. When the shadows fall, the promise of it all is lost inside the tears that linger on. All the things we'd hoped would always keep us close stand between us now as fences. Letters that we wrote have all gone up in smoke, and now you're just too far to listen.
So that is David Sylvian. Very, very good singer. Has that cerebral effect on you, man. Making you think, making you visualize, making you feel, you know, sympathize, go within. All of that sort of thing. He's definitely got a really, really great way of conveying what he's trying to get you to see and feel. And how to think. That takes some skills. Let me tell you, as an artist, with that kind of creative edge, you know, it's one of those things that you possess or that you don't, it seems, you know, and this dude certainly has that, man. Brother's got skills. So, this is what we'll do. Let's take a look at the man and then take a look at the album, get a feel for, where he's been, how he's come up, and why he writes the way he writes, that sort of thing. Yeah, really, really good, man. I would say for me, probably the standout song is Orpheus. I really dig that one, man. That was really good. They're all good. Definitely none of them I would skip if I was to play this over and over again. But Orpheus is the one that I would be listening for the most. You know what I'm saying? All right. So, let's do this, man. Let's get a little background on the man. So, David Sylvian. Born David Allen Batt. The 23rd of February, 1958. Oh, wow. It's the 22nd. So, happy birthday to you tomorrow, man. Is an English artist, singer, songwriter, and musician who came to prominence in the late 70s as frontman and principal songwriter of the band Japan. The band's androgynous look and increasingly electronic sound made them an important influence in the UK's early 80s new romantic scene. Following their breakup, Sylvian embarked on a solo career with his debut album Brilliant Trees in 84. His solo work has been described by AllMusic as far-ranging and esoteric, and has included collaborations with artists such as Ryuichi Sakamoto, Robert Fripp, Holger Tsukai, CZUKAY, John Hassell, Bill Nelson, and Finesse. While his recordings of the 80s and 90s were a mixture of pop, jazz fusion, and avant-garde experimentalism mixed with ambient, his more recent compositions have drawn increasingly on musical minimalism and free improvisation. Secrets of the Beehive. Secrets of the Beehive is a solo album by British singer-songwriter David Sylvian, and it was released on the 19th of October in 87. In Europe, UK, and America, the album peaked at number 37 in the UK album chart. The album was released in Japan on the 21st of November in 87. Background. Sylvian said in an interview in 2012 about the album, quote, "That's an odd record, really, because just prior to that, I'd been on a really extensive press tour for Gone to Earth, which was just taking me all over the globe, and I was quite exhausted talking about the work and didn't feel quite ready to sit down and embrace writing at that moment in time. But it just started coming to me. As soon as I had settled back into my home, the material started arriving, and in a period of about 2 weeks, everything was written." Damn, that's some inspiration, let me tell you. "And it wasn't something that I planned on doing. I hadn't conceived the album in its entirety as an entity in itself. It's just a batch of songs that sort of arrived and fell in my lap. It felt like a gift. I recognized that there was a beauty to the material, and it already felt to me like something I had heard before. It felt like it was going to be around for a while, and I don't know why it felt that way, but every time I returned to one of the pieces, it felt so familiar, like this had been around a very long time. It's going to be around for a long time to come. So it was very much a gift to me in that respect." Interesting. Secrets of the Beehive was met with a considerable amount of hostility in the press, and on top of that, there were pieces missing that I had never got to complete. I just ran out of budget, and there wasn't any more forthcoming to allow me to complete the record as I envisioned it. So although I liked the material on the album, the centerpiece is missing. So for me, it was something of a failure. Interesting. The missing piece was the song Ride, which was later completed and finally released in 2000 on the compilation album Everything and Nothing. Sylvian said, "I was crushed when I wasn't able to finish it first time around due to time and budget restraints." Yeah, a lot of artists have that hurdle, it seems. Sad, man. You got to see your vision to the end. You know, you got to give that to an artist if you're in a position of influence and power to help them do that. Secrets of the Beehive was his most intimate to date, and used more acoustic instruments than ever before, by many regarded as his finest solo work. Produced by Steve Nye and David Sylvian, the album features Ryuichi Sakamoto, David Torn, Mark Isham, Phil Palmer, Danny Thompson, and Steve Jansen. Sylvian and Nye would travel to France and the Netherlands to record much of the album before completing it in England. The orchestral overdubs were recorded midway through the album at Angel Studios and at Air in London. Sakamoto had scored the majority of the songs except Orpheus and Let the Happiness In. They were scored by arranger Brian Gashion, who had also worked with Scott Walker. The album was completed early summer 88 at Tears for Fears Woo Hall Studios in Beckington. In 2003, a remastered limited digipack version of Secrets of the Beehive was released with a bonus track from the Japanese version, Promise, The Cult of Eurydice, replacing the original CD bonus track, Forbidden Colors, which was a re-recorded version of the Sakamoto Sylvian collaboration, originally intended for Brilliant Trees, but eventually released as B-side to the Red Guitar single. In 2006, it was reissued in a standard jewel case. In February 2019, as part of a redesigned monochrome sleeved vinyl reissue batch of the 80s album Secrets, it was released in a gatefold sleeve with different type of fonts, but otherwise maintaining the original artwork. Okay, and so that's the information given for this really, really cool album, man. Very, very nice. You know, there's definitely certain times where you would want to put this on. I couldn't listen to it every day, of course, but, you know, not all albums are meant to be listened to every single day. But there are definitely times where this would really serve very, very well. Really nice, chilling time. I like to keep my Sundays free all for myself. And Sundays, it's kind of like my hallowed day. Maybe it was going all the way back to when I was a kid, and you know, the way you were kind of raised, that it was a hallowed day, go to church and don't do much of anything else, don't labor, don't work, you know, malls shouldn't be open, all of that sort of thing. So I guess I got my hallowedness about Sunday from that. So on a Sunday, my own time, the girlfriend's not around, it's just me, myself, and I would put on something like this, you know what I mean? So it's got those times, it's got those moments, or just chilling out after a long ass day, something like that, and you just want to think about something else and let your mind go elsewhere. It serves its purposes, that's for sure. And David Sylvian really has a way with using his voice and getting you to kind of get a feel for things. And yeah, man, very skilled artist here. So with that said, back to voiceover. So thank you, man. I appreciate the recommendation, and thanks for introducing me to a new artist. If you're hearing about this guy for the first time and he's new to you and you think he's all that, let me know, man. It'll be really cool to see what you think about this guy. So Joshua, Charles, Ancap, Alan, I've got reactions I got to hit up for you, gents. So that's going to be coming up in the next couple of days. I want to squeeze as many reactions in as I can over the next week, because the following week is going to be a busy one, so reactions are going to slow down. So that's what I've got coming up, man. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this. I enjoyed this very much. And like I said, this music would really, really apply in at certain times, in certain moods and stuff like that. So next time you see me, it'll be tomorrow. And that is Joshua. I got three Joshuas. This is Joshua Sane. So Joshua, your reaction is tomorrow. I can't remember if it's what it is, but all the same, you'll see me tomorrow. Peace out.